For the first time, the United States government today warned American companies and individuals about the risks of doing business, studying, or investing in Hong Kong. The Biden administration also sanctioned Hong Kong officials and accused them of eroding the city's freedoms as the Chinese government continues to force its will on Hong Kong. Here's Nick Schifrin.
Judy, today's business advisory says because of the 2020 national security law that Beijing imposed on Hong Kong, Americans are at risk of arrest, and businesses are at risk of electronic warrantless surveillance, restricted access to information because of a crackdown on the media, and Chinese legal consequences if they comply with American sanctions. Also today, the U.S. sanctioned 7 officials in the Chinese Communist Party's primary office in Hong Kong. For more on all this, we turn to Michael Hirson, the China lead for the Eurasia Group, an international business consulting firm. Michael Hirson, welcome back to the NewsHour. How significant is it that the U.S., for the first time, has issued this advisory about Hong Kong?
Well, I don't think the findings in the advisory are going to be anything new or shocking to the business community. It does represent, I think, something of a deterioration in Hong Kong's business environment. And it also shows you that the Biden administration is quite willing to push the envelope, essentially, on this issue, even though it's quite sensitive to China.
You talk to businesses in Hong Kong. What are they saying? Are they planning on any changes because of this business advisory?
I don't think the advisory is going to lead to any kind of rapid change in terms of how businesses view Hong Kong. I think for financial services companies, Hong Kong is really still important as a capital gateway to China. But I think there are other companies who have maybe used Hong Kong as an Asia regional hub for whom this is going to matter. It's going to play in conversations, for example, with their board, where there's a diversity of views as to whether or not it makes sense to be in Hong Kong. And now that the State Department has put out this advisory, I think it does give a further color to those conversations.
Let me zoom into the final warning in the warning today, and that American businesses could face Chinese legal consequences just for following American sanctions. That actually hasn't happened yet, but our business is worried about it.
It's a serious concern. It means that this two-way political risk that companies face is not just about values issues like how you talk about Hong Kong or Taiwan or Tibet, but it's really about policies. It is actually becoming, you know, illegal to implement U.S. sanctions, U.S. laws in Hong Kong. Now, I think the reality is likely to be a bit nuanced here because I think Hong Kong authorities are going to be careful not to disrupt Hong Kong's role as a financial center. But it is an area that is, I think, fairly new for firms. And just given the sweeping nature of some of these Chinese laws, it's certainly a possibility.
We recently talked to a Hong Kong resident and activist, Glacier Kong, who moved to Europe because after the national security law was imposed, she didn't feel safe in Hong Kong. Let's take a listen to what she said.
I think one of the most visible changes I see is people self-centering themselves. Like, people are afraid to talk about things, like, because under the law, a lot of things are not allowed. The freedom of the press is no longer existing. The freedom of speech, the freedom of expression, the freedom of peaceful assemblies, these are all gone.
Do businesses share those concerns?
They do. So the canary in the coal mine here, you know, are the sectors that are most sensitive to the information environment, and that's technology companies and media companies. And several of those firms have already announced that they're leaving Hong Kong. Something like financial services is a bit of a more nuanced area. They're less directly exposed, and so they're worried about it, but it's not yet the kind of factor that would lead them to leave Hong Kong.
For many years, Hong Kong has been one of, if not the, financial hub in Asia. Bottom line, has that already changed?
It has changed. Essentially, what's happening is Hong Kong is transitioning from being a global business hub, even an Asian business hub, to more of a capital gateway to China. So, ironically, Hong Kong's importance to the financial sector has actually increased because of U.S.-China financial tensions. So, Hong Kong is now the place where Chinese companies are going public. It's where U.S. and other investors go to gain exposure to those companies, and it's where financial services firms need to be. But the notion that Hong Kong is kind of an all-purpose hub, it's where you would put your data center or where you would put your technology or media operations, I think that's already changed.
Michael Hirson, thank you very much.
Thank you.